The Vanguard anti-cheat system that Riot Games made especially for Valorant has been the talk of the town the last couple of days. Some players are not that happy that the service runs as soon as you start up your computer, while other people do not care one bit. But for this video, it doesn't matter on which side of the spectrum you are at, since I believe that this bit of news is something positive for everyone. In this video, I will discuss the news that got released that Riot will actually reward hackers for breaking Vanguard and how it shows their dedication to ban cheaters from their game. If you like the video or learn something from it, a like and a sub would be greatly appreciated. Let's take a look at Riot's insane initiative to make Vanguard the best anti-cheat system on the market. Getting a good anti-cheat software setup for your game is something really important, I think. We all agree. I'm looking at you, Warzone. Please fix this. I don't want to keep dying to people with random names. And even the CSGO community has been plagued by hackers the last couple of years, which breaks the experience for players and is just simply put, not a fun time. Riot made Vanguard, an anti-cheat software especially made for Valorant, but can also be used in other games if Riot ever wants to sell the property to a different company. So Riot investing into this isn't only good for Valorant, it might be a positive change for more games to come as well. Riot is extremely dedicated to fix the issue and shows this by actually giving a bounty to hackers that manage to bypass or break their systems. This week they put up rewards on HackerOne.com, a platform where companies can ask hackers to try and invade their intellectual properties and tell them how they did this in case they succeed. This is an insanely clever and useful way to detect any loopholes in the system and also a great way for hackers to actually make some money. Riot is rewarding them with up to $100,000 in different categories to test their software. Of course, Riot has money for days to fund their games and also anti-cheat systems, but still, $100,000 seems like a lot of money. I guess a lot of hackers got happy when they saw this pop up on HackerOne. Riot listed the following categories with the following rewards. Hackers can earn money in the Network Attack with No User Interaction category by code execution on the kernel level. For this, they get $100,000 if they manage to do this. Also, unauthorized access to sensitive data. Next to that, they can earn money in the category Network Attack requiring user interaction with one click. For this, they need to code execution on the kernel level. They get $75,000 in fee. Next to that, unauthorized access to sensitive data. It's $50,000. This is also a lot of money just to gain access to some sensitive data. Next to that, there is the local attack for privilege escalation section. For this, they need to code execution on the kernel level, $35,000, and unauthorized access to sensitive data, again, $25,000. On the website itself, Riot explains further what these details actually mean and what they are looking for from the guys that are trying to enter their systems. So if you are more curious about the details, I will link the article below so you can read more about them if you'd like. I don't know about you guys, but when I saw this, I was about to call my boss and tell him I quit and start to learn how to hack anti-cheat software. But any jokes aside, bypassing the security should actually be really hard, or else the Riot developers didn't do a very good job. This system is designed to find stuff they couldn't think of, and I expect Riot to have their doors sealed shut. We have seen some activity of people blatantly hacking, even on live streams, but those actions got nipped in the butt really quickly, for what I've seen so far. People not being able to hack in a game like Valorant is extremely important, especially when the ranked system comes into play. CSGO players have stated before that hackers is one of the main issues that they left the game, and could actually ruin Valorant as a new game if Riot doesn't run a tidy ship. This isn't, by the way, the first time that Riot is letting the public break their games to make it a better environment. In 2017, Riot released an article in which they explained why they let hackers break their stuff and test out their systems. They found that through the forums, they could get into all chatting software at Riot Games and pose as each employee at the company. Stuff like this is awesome when found behind closed doors, but not so much when the public finds out. After they found that leak in the system, they asked people to come forward and offer them jobs if they are good at hacking and writing code, and said they already hired the first people straight from Reddit. Stuff like this makes me believe in the longevity of Valorant. Riot wants to make this work, and is and was already dedicated years ago. I honestly don't know why people would hack in a video game, I don't see the fun of it, and if everyone would just play fair, we don't need any of this stuff. But in the end, this pays the bills for the hackers that find the cracks in the software like Valorant. So I guess the hackers are creating jobs for the good guy hackers at the same time. What goes around, comes around. I hope to see you guys all in-game soon. Not hacking, of course. And I also hope to see you in the next one. Peace.